Hi, today we'll see these electronic boards assembly. There are four boards interconnected. According to the seller, this stuff was installed in a Ukrainian military stuff, which is Stugna-P, but I am not sure, okay? So Stugna-P is a missile launcher. So we can see that there is a strong conformal coating. Actually, there are two layers of conformal coating. The first one is a hard conformal coating. And above the first conformal coating, there is another one, which is this one here, which is a soft one, a kind of silicone gel. I don't know. I bought that thing because one board is complete. Actually, two boards are complete. This one here and this one also. And there is here a strange assembly. So there is a PCB, which is mounted on this square holder here. And you can see it is possible to adjust the position of the PCB. And there are two screws which permit to lock the PCB in place. And there is a pivot here, you can see. So actually the PCB can rotate here, something like that. Okay, so you can adjust the angle actually of the PCB regarding the holder here. I did the reverse engineering of this assembly here, more or less complete. So it is interesting. So first we can have a look on that part. So this part is actually a MEMS gyro. It is a gyro from Analog Devices, an ADXRS453, if I remember. Okay, it communicates with the other board here using an SPI bus. On that board, another interesting part, which is this one. So this is an accelerometer. If I remember, it is an ADXL1001. The range is 100 G's, I think. Okay, so here there is a microcontroller from Atmel, an ATMEGA168. It is an automotive part. I think it is quite reliable because the maximum temperature is 150 degrees. The gyro is connected to the SPI bus of this microcontroller. The accelerometer has an analog output. It is connected to one ADC input of this microcontroller. There is a clock oscillator here and a voltage regulator for the analog power supply. And there is here a ribbon cable. There is here a comparator. So on the ribbon cable, there are two inputs actually which are connected to the comparator. The outputs of the comparator are connected to an OR gate, which is this small tiny part here in SOT5. And the output is connected to one pin of the microcontroller. Okay, so there is a UART communication between the microcontroller and the other board, and there are also a few lines connected. So the second board is also interesting with this small DC-DC converter. Okay, so the main part is this one. So this is a brushless motor controller. Okay, we can see the six transistors here. So we have three MOSFETs here and three PNP transistors here. So this board is actually a servo control loop. Okay, so the input is actually a voltage which is given by a DAC which is on that board here. The position is given, okay, by the brushless motor which should be connected here. So this connector should be connected to an electromechanical assembly, okay, with a motor and a feedback potentiometer. I don't know exactly what it's supposed to be controlled. Okay, it is maybe the position of an optical stuff. And there are also some parts on the bottom side. A few passive parts. The last board is also interesting. This board is more or less an interface board. You can see that there are several connectors. So here there are four MOSFETs, or there are some autocouplers also, you can see. So I didn't do the reverse engineering of that stuff because there is nothing interesting on that board. But you can see here there are two large ICs. So this part was actually present. It is a DSP from Texas 320F. This part was held only by one or two pins here, so this part is lost somewhere in my house. But the second part was not present. Okay, on that side, there are also several parts.
This is a schematic diagram of the gyro board. There is nothing special, it corresponds to the schematics which is in the datasheet of the part. There are two lines for the power supply, here the ground and plus 5 volts, and there are four lines for the SPI bus. We have here the accelerometer ADXL1001. A lot of pins are not used. There is a non-analog output, which is this line here, which is fed to this voltage follower. And we can see a small low-pass filter at the output here. And this line goes to an ADC input of the microcontroller. We have here the microcontroller, the ATMEGA168. There is a clock oscillator here. I don't know the frequency of this oscillator. We have here on the right the SPI bus for the gyro. Here, this is the input of the accelerometer. There is a reset line. And there are four lines here, which are connected to the second board. And we have here four test points. We can see that two lines correspond to the UART interface, okay, transmit and receive lines. These two lines permit the communication between this microcontroller and the main controller. We have here a circuit which permits the interface between the ribbon cable here with 10 lines and the microcontroller, which is this line here. There is a dual comparator, an LM2903. One threshold is 0 volt, which is this line. And there is a second threshold of approximately the power supply line here. Okay, so there is also an hysteresis on both comparators. The two outputs are fed to this NOR gate here, and the output is fed to the microcontroller and also to the main board. I don't know what is the purpose of that circuit because I don't know what is connected to this ribbon cable. This is the schematic diagram of the servo control board. The main part is in the middle of that page here, MC35033. This is a brushless motor controller. Okay, we can see the stator of this motor, the rotor using several magnets, and we have normally three hole sensors here which permits to detect the rotation of the rotor here. The input of the servo control is this DAC here. Position is set using an SPI bus here. Okay, and there is also a feedback potentiometer, which is represented here on the right. Okay, so let's see in details how this thing works. This is a brushless motor controller. The outputs are fed to three MOSFETs here for the low side and to three PNP transistors for the high side Q. There is one digital input here which permits to change the direction of rotation, forward or reverse. And there is another input here, which is an analog input, actually pin 12 here, which permits to set the pulse width modulation voltage, which permits to set the speed of the motor. So there are two methods actually to set the speed. The first method is to use this op-amp as a voltage follower. In that case, you connect the pin 12 and 13 together, and the voltage input is pin 11. It is not the present solution. The present solution is to use this op-amp as a transimpedance amplifier. So we can see that the positive input pin here is connected to ground. Okay, and the inverting input here is connected to the output using an external resistor of 10k. So therefore, we should have a negative current here, that is to say a current flowing from right to left here, in order to have a positive voltage on that line. So the input of that circuit is a sink current here. Actually, it was not possible to read the marking for that part. I have checked several DACs and I found this one from Texas, DAC 7562, which seems compatible, okay, with the reverse engineering here. So we have pins 3 and 4 which are connected to ground. Okay, pin 1 and 2 should be the two outputs of the DAC. I assume this is the dual output DAC. Pin 10 is the reference voltage. It is connected to a test point. You can use the reference voltage as an input or an output. I have checked that nothing is connected to that pin, so therefore the internal reference voltage is used. Pin 9 is the power supply, and we have 4 lines for an SPI bus. These lines should be connected to the DSP processor. The output of the DAC is fed to this non-inverting amplifier, okay, with a gain of 3. I was not able neither to read the reference of that part, but the pinout is compatible with the classic dual op-amp. We can see here a summing amplifier. Okay, so the first voltage here corresponds to the feedback voltage. This voltage should be negative. And the second voltage is the output of the DAC, which permits to set the position. This point is the virtual ground. The mechanical stuff is stabilized, we should have a null current here, that is to say a null voltage at the output of this op-amp. This voltage is an error voltage actually. This voltage is fed to an amplifier here with a gain of approximately 3. There is an RC network here which permits to optimize the step response of that system. Okay, this is a phase correction. Okay, so this voltage is fed to two different circuits. The first one is a comparator which permits to set the direction here according to the polarity of this voltage. The second circuit is this one. So this circuit permits to give the absolute value of that voltage. This voltage should be always positive. If the motor rotates in one direction or another one at a given speed, this voltage should be the same. Only this line permits to change the direction of rotation. Okay, so let's see how this absolute value circuit works. This is the absolute value circuit. This voltage can be positive or negative, and we need that this voltage is positive, whatever the direction of rotation is. Let's assume for the moment that this voltage is positive, for example, plus V. Okay, so this line is a virtual ground, okay, because it is the input of this op-amp, so second input is connected to ground. Okay, so therefore there will be a current flowing here of plus V divided by 20k. Okay, if this voltage is positive, this voltage will be negative, so therefore this diode will be off, okay, because this point is at 0 volt. Therefore this diode will be forward biased, so therefore this voltage will be at minus V. Okay, so this is actually an inverting amplifier with a gain of minus 1. So we have a minus V here, so therefore the current flowing through this resistor is minus V divided by 10. So therefore the current flowing here is the sum of these two currents. That is to say minus V divided by 20k. So let's assume now that this voltage is negative. In that case, we will have here a current of minus V divided by 20k. The output here will be positive. In that case, this diode will be forward biased. There will be here a voltage of approximately 0.7 volt. This diode is off because the voltage here is 0, and this one also. So this diode is reverse biased. That means that no current flows through these two resistors here. So that means that this current is minus V divided by 20k as well. Okay, so if we have a voltage of plus or minus V here, we have a current of minus V divided by 20k. That means here a voltage of V divided by 2. That means that the velocity of the motor is the same if we have a voltage of plus V or minus V at that point here.